Welcome to Cheek to Cheek Wrestling. I am your host, Toya-Tim-Mania. And like I said before, Tim was here. My co-host, Tim.
I am here.
Hi. The mark.
Shut up. Shut up and get on with things.
The mark. Anyways, who was also sick, Mark?
I'm gonna bloody mark you, what I'm gonna do when I see you.
I'm so scared. Anyways, we're gonna be talking about, obviously, the biggest event of our careers. Well, not our careers, but our Russian wrestling careers. WrestleMania. So, yeah.
Watching wrestling and talking about a career, that's
yes,
a good career.
Yes, great career. Too bad we don't get paid for this career, but yeah, we should.
Exactly. One day we might actually make something for it, but there we are.
Well, as you may know, WrestleMania is on two nights, so we'll do both nights. We're going to do night one first, and then we'll give you night two afterwards, obviously, because that's how numbers work. Unless,
in general, yes.
I mean, unless you're like progressive,
I mean,
leftist, and you
unless
want, like,
it's opposite day, so we do day two first. That's also a possibility,
I mean, that's
of course.
Two,
but,
or unless you feel two is more important than one, we can.
We're just gonna
do the old school way. Right, Tim.
Fair enough.
If I miss one, let me know.
Yeah, I will.
Of night one. Okay. Well, anyway, first match we're gonna talk about is Seth Rollins versus Logan Paul.
We said this before, this is going to be an absolutely amazing match, and I'm going to absolutely hate myself for enjoying something Logan Paul is part of. That's really all I can say. Again, it's Seth Rollins. Logan Paul is a great athlete. I hate having to say it, but you can't get around it. Seth Rollins is Seth Rollins. They're going to have a great match. It's really that simple. I am going to say Logan Paul is going to win it because he's a celebrity and it's Mania. So, yeah, that, I guess, is my prediction for that one.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
I mean, there are rumors that it's the last thing Logan Paul will do with the company because of his current legal trouble. So he's at least going to take an extended break, if nothing else. If that's the case, I guess I could see Seth winning it if they want to do something big with him and he needs some momentum. But again, it's WrestleMania and Logan Paul is a celebrity, so
yeah
I put my money on a Mr. Paul.
Yeah, I think he's gonna win too, but I'm just like, I'm just not happy about it.
Exactly.
Alright, guys, we're gonna talk about next match.
Yeah!
Ow, that was loud.
Yeah.
Anyways, next match is for the United States title. Austin Theory will defend his title against John Cena.
Gonna be first match of the evening, by the way, and
yes.
Man, the arena is going to explode when Cena walks in.
Yes.
I mean, Theory is going to win, right?
I believe.
I have to win.
I think this is like passing the buck off to Gossip Theory.
Yeah. I mean, either Theory is going to win or it's going to have to be a
disqualification or something.
Disqualification or something. But,
yeah.
I mean, Cena isn't sticking. I mean, you know what? I would love Cena to stick around for like a 3-month run, one last title shot, even if it's just the US title.
Right. I would like to see it too.
But I would absolutely love that. I just don't think it's going to happen.
Oh, I don't think so either. But I mean, like I said, I would like to see it, but you're right, probably won't happen.
No. But again, I think this match can be fun. If it is Cena's last match, for instance, which is not completely impossible, then I'm sure he's going to give it his all, and we have seen Austin Theory being extremely good with others. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this.
I mean, this is kind of the match we've been like kind of wanting to see for a while. They've been like hinting at it for a while and everything. So
yeah,
I think it's gonna be a good match because I think they say like, you know, Austin Theory has like the same like kind of moves as John Cena does and everything like that. So it's gonna be pretty good. I'm gonna enjoy it and like I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, no, I feel exactly the same. Again, I think Austin's going to win, but yeah, I'm super looking forward to the match itself. It's going to be so cool.
Alright, well, we're going to pick Austin for the win. Go to the next match, which is a 6 women's tag team match. We got the team of Trish Stratus with the women's tag team championship, Becky Lynch, and later will go against Damage Control, Bayley, Io Sky, and Dakota Kai.
Yep.
Now, if they want to keep Damage Control strong, then they have to win. However, I don't know if that's going to be the case. Because a lot of people, I heard, Tim said that he heard that Trish Stratus might go against Lita and them, but it's like,
I mean, it's just the dirt sheets that's reporting that they are considering a Trish heel turn. In that case, I mean, that's what I'm putting my money on, just because it's so persistent. That Trish is going to turn, and Damage Control is going to is going to win and retain, and then we have a Trish versus Becky feud.
I mean, is that a thing?
I don't know if it's a thing, but I mean, it's just what everyone says.
Because I mean, I know that Trish had a problem with Bayley, but did you have a problem with Becky? Unless she took like Becky took her best friend Lita.
Maybe Trish wants to be the heel. I mean, I can't remember the last time Trish was a heel. Back when she was a manager, I guess, or a valet or something. I don't know. Again, if Trish turns, and I think Trish turns, just because everyone is so serious about it, then I think Damage Control wins. If Trish doesn't turn,
I mean,
the other side has to win, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, if Damage Control, if they want to keep this strong hold or whatever, they have to win. But, like, I don't know. That whole Trish thing. I mean, I'm not saying it's not possible. This is WWE. It is possible. But, like, yeah, I don't know. It's odd. Just a little bit odd, but whatever. Yes.
Yeah.
One of the 3 ladies will win.
Yes. Out of the 6 ladies involved in the match, I'm pretty sure some of them will win.
Yes, I'm sure some of them will win. Yeah. We'll just go with that.
I'll put my money on Damage Control, because holy crap, they need it more than the faces do.
Yes, they really do. That's what I'm saying. But alright, well, let's move on, shall we? We got Tim's favorite match of the night. That's going to be Brock Lesnar versus Omos.
Oh, man. This is the one. This is where I'm going to be glued to the action.
Yes.
Glued, I tell you.
Glued.
Like, glued. More excited than anything. Oh, sorry. I fell asleep for some reason. I don't know why.
Wake up, Tim.
I mean, Brock kinda have to win it, right?
I guess. I don't even know.
I mean, I don't know what they... I still don't know what they're doing with Omos. It's obvious he's not... I mean, he has improved. There's no question he's improved. But he's not nearly good enough to, like, get into a main title run. They already have Braun if they want, like, the monster there.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what the point of him is right now, to be honest, but...
I don't know.
I just
steal some space.
Yeah? I mean, it's to get Brock Lesnar on the card. That's basically what it is. I mean, to a certain degree, if Brock wins, it's sort of like Brock has lost a lot recently because he's been up against Roman and Bobby.
Yeah.
I mean, have him beat Omos and suddenly he's a monster again? I mean,
I guess that would work.
This is 100%, like, 100% the P-break match.
Yes.
Without question.
Yes. Which is pretty sad, because it's really big dudes. It was like, it's also really a big pre-break, too.
There's going to be a lot of beef in that ring. That's all I can say.
All the beef.
all the beef.
Alright, good.
But I'll put my money on Brock.
Yeah, I'll put on Brock, too.
Just because it's Brock.
Alright, next match, we got the Women's World Championship match will be defended.
Yep.
Bianca Belair versus Asuka. I'm going with
this
Asuka.
I'm going with Asuka, too, but this is actually the only sort of real complaint, I guess, I have about the build-up to Mania. Holy crap, does it feel like this match has been forgotten.
Yeah.
We've hardly seen any of them. I am much more excited for this match than I am for the next women's title match.
Yes.
Not that I'm not excited for that one, but this one is the one where I'm like, this is going to be, I mean, if these two are this can be a show stealer if these two are giving us a full performance. And we haven't seen any of them for weeks.
I mean, you see them off and on, but it's one like...
Yeah, but I mean, there hasn't been really a build. It's just like, okay, these people are going to have a match. Okay, it doesn't feel like a feud. Okay, sometimes it doesn't need to be a feud. Sometimes it's just a match. But it's like, even the go-home Raw, I mean, unless I missed something, they weren't on the go-home Raw at all. Either of them.
No. You're right, which is weird.
Very strange.
Really weird.
Anyway, it's going to be, I think it's going to be a complete match stealer.
Yeah.
Show stealer, and I think Asuka needs to win it. Bianca has held the title for a long time now, and with the repackaging of Asuka,
there is a chance to
turn Asuka into the incredibly dominant character she can be. And, like, push her all the way up there to the top of the women's division. So I think Asuka's going to win.
Yeah.
I hope she does.
I mean, I hope so, too. That's the hope, anyway. But, yeah, I kind of agree with you with the whole, like, setup thing. It's, like, kind of like, eh. The way they put it. I mean, it's going to be a good match because these women are, like, amazing.
No,
but it's, like,
absolutely.
I would have liked for them to build it up a little bit more.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm just like,
especially
because
it's for a belt. You know, you think it's for a championship.
Almost every other singles match. I mean, even Cena and Austin feels like they have had. I mean, Cena hasn't been there, but Austin has been trying to carry this entirely. Even Lesnar and Omos have gotten some build up.
Right.
This one has just been feeling like, okay, it's there.
Because they're minorities.
Yeah, like this is WWE discriminating against blacks and Asians. That's
right.
What this is.
Yes. Alright, well, I got the last match. I don't know if it's actually the last match, but we'll find out. Tim will let me know.
Yeah.
We got the SmackDown Women's Championship match. Charlotte Flair versus Rhea Ripley, who was the Royal Rumble winner.
Rhea's gotta win it, right?
She has to win. She has to win this match for a few reasons. One, to make Judgment Day look strong.
Yeah.
Two, because...
And also because I think there is a Judgment Day loss coming later.
Yes.
Where a Rhea win is going to be very important.
Yes.
To counterbalance that. Also, Charlotte doesn't need the title right now. No offense to... Like, unlike other people, I'm always happy with Charlotte having the title. I love Charlotte. That's a well-established fact. But she doesn't need the title right now. And both Rhea and Judgment Day kind of do.
Yeah.
So I would give that to Rhea.
Give it to Rhea, she'll take it.
It's gonna be a fun match. Definitely going to be a fun match. It seems like it's going to be like main event of day one.
Yes.
So
I'm really excited to see
good.
That one. I'm really excited to see that one.
Yeah.
Because I always said it was always weird to see Charlotte Flair as a face, but whatever.
Yeah, I mean, listen, she can do it, it's fine, but we've talked about this before. I don't know if we talked about it on stream or on live, but some people just get so good and or so comfortable, maybe, or so just set in a role that you can't really see them otherwise.
Yes.
It's like, you know, Randy Orton. Even when he's a face, he's still, you know, Randy Orton.
Right.
He does. Some people, when they change between face and heel, they completely change personality.
Kind of like Bayley.
Sorry?
Like Bayley?
Yeah, like Bailey, for instance. Yeah, yeah. Like, total personality shift. Like, Charlotte doesn't really. She just isn't quite as...
mean?
Asshole. Mean and assholeish as usual, right?
Right.
I mean, Rhea basically changed personality to a certain degree when she did her heel turn.
Yes.
Brock obviously have different it's more to a degree, but again, take someone like Charlotte. I mean, take someone like Charlotte's father, Rick. I mean, Rick wrestled the same for 30 years. Didn't matter who he was still Rick. Eddie Guerrero, doesn't matter if he was heel or face, he was still, you know, basically an asshole. You know, yeah. I lie, I cheat, I steal. God, I miss Eddie. There's just some things there, but yeah, no, I think Rhea's gonna take this. I hope Rhea takes this.
Yeah, she should take it. She should take it. Well, anyway, that is it for night uno. One.
Yeah. Let's do a little... I don't actually know if all the other matches are set. I don't actually know if all the other matches are officially set for night two, but these are the ones that are officially on night one, so they might switch it around a little
bit. They might switch it around, so don't take our word for it, but I'm just giving you the matches that I just know.
Yeah.
Anyways, night two. What's up, guys? We're back. Night two. Hey. Anyways.
Hey.
And night two.
That was night one. And if you want to hear about night two, we shall talk about it.
Now.
Right now.
So, right night two, I got Edge versus Finn Balor in a Hell in a Cell match.
Demon Finn even. Which is weird. Because I think that's the first time since he came back from Japan that Demon Finn has been a heel.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not complaining, I'm just saying. Demon Finn has always been like, you know... what Finn Balor goes to if he absolutely needs to dig deep. It makes sense. Against Edge, this feud has been going on for, 9 months now.
Forever!
And it's a Hell in a Cell match. This is obviously going to be the final, the absolute final
one.
Well,
there has to
be. So it completely makes sense. It's just, it's weird that they are going with the demon for him as a heel, because...
Well, this is him that he has to beat Edge.
Yeah, I don't think he will.
I'm kind of on the fence with this one. I don't know, because this is Demon, supposedly.
Yeah.
No one could beat Demon except for, like, maybe Rollins.
I mean,
Roman, but, like, still.
Demon Balor has only ever lost one match since he returned from Japan. And that was...
against Roman Reigns.
Roman.
Yeah, well, we're gonna talk about that.
A completely different thing. So yeah, I would put my money on Finn as well, but I also kind of feel like...
Because I feel like...
it's Edge.
I mean, I feel like technically Edge got his moment at the last pay-per-view with...
At the same time,
no, he didn't, so I don't know, and it's like... it's like, Edge has to win to finally end this.
Yeah.
End it, for sure. Like,
I at the same time, another Judgment Day win would position them incredibly strongly for whatever we are going to do after Mania. And it's not like Edge needs the win. I mean, Edge can just come back for another match at SummerSlam, not with Finn, but for something else.
Yeah.
It's still Edge. He's still going to get, you know...
the
he's still going to be as strong and cheered as ever. There's nothing there. So it's not... fuck. I have a doubt.
I'm on the fence. I'm on the fence.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'm just thinking Edge because it's like... it's Edge, right?
I mean, it's
There's
Edge.
Probably not a single
it's,
more popular star
it's
on the
Edge.
Roster right now.
It's Edge. He has beaten so many people in Hell in the Cell.
Yeah.
It's kind of his thing, and it's like, but it's like...
And I don't know if Finn just needs the win. Like, if Rhea wins and the third Judgment Day match also goes their way, does Finn really need... But at the same time, if he is the leader...
He might need to win.
Can't really lose with the other people winning.
I mean,
so
it's a tough call.
Okay, I'm going to put my money... rethinking. I'm going to put my money on Finn, but, like, with the smallest of margins.
All right.
It can be Ed.
Yeah,
just
I'm gonna go
easily.
With the same thing. I'm gonna say Finn.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say Finn because he needs it more, I think. Than
Edge. Than Edge, yeah.
So, okay, guys. Well, since we're gonna stay on Judgment Day, let's just stay on Judgment Day, right?
Yeah, let's get that
okay.
out of the way.
So we're gonna have Rey Mysterio versus Dominique Mysterio. Father versus son match. He's gonna whip him with a belt.
I felt that this match has been too long in the coming.
Yes.
But at the same time, the build to it recently, when they decided to go for it, the build to it has been fantastic.
Also,
like,
yes.
Really fantastic.
Yes.
Until like 3 days ago, I was sure Dominic was going to win. Because Rey is going to be indicted into the whole. Indicted, my goodness. Inducted.
Indicted? Is he Trump?
Rey is going to be indicted into the Hall of Fame any day soon. Then
yeah,
gonna
they're going to put some handcuffs on him and throw him in the Hall of
yeah.
Fame. Can you imagine?
It could be amazing. It would be so funny. Rey is going to be inducted into the Hall of Fame. In general, when people go into the Hall of Fame, their career is at least on the downturn.
Right.
Like, it's on its way to a retirement.
Right.
So I would say that, you know, Rey would want to go out with, or end his career, or if not end his career, then at least slow it down to become like, he could become like, you know, Edge and Cena. Someone who comes back for spectacle matches. It would be fine. But I would think he would end his, like, full-time career elevating Dominic.
Yeah, I mean, it would...
By losing.
It would
but
be good.
But at the same time, he said just 3 days ago that he wasn't actually planning on a full retirement. He would at least expect one more year full-time. And if that's the case, then the storyline really needs Rey
to
win.
Win. Yes. I mean, I always thought Rey should win anyway, the way that storyline was been going, where it's like,
yeah.
Oh, you know, I'm not going to hit my son, and my son, but now my son yelled at my wife and
yeah,
mother.
Dominic
oh, no,
really
that's not.
Deserves his comeuppance
right.
right now.
Yeah.
Like, really deserves his comeuppance now. This is where he'll
so
have
I,
to lose.
So, right. I figure if Rhea wins. Finn wins.
Yeah.
It's okay for Dominic to lose.
To lose, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I go with it. But at the same time, if Rey is actually slowing down, then having Dominic win would be really good for Dominic. If those
of,
two
of
can
course.
Pull off a really good match, and I mean Dominic has been playing his role fantastic recently. He's been much better than I thought he would be with the Judgment Day, except for the stupid. Mullet, but I guess it fits the character. but I don't know. I'm still gonna put my money on Dominic. But
right.
Again,
well, I'm gonna go opposite and say it's Rey.
Fair enough. I mean, mine is only based on Rey going into the hole, and that's usually a sign of career winding down. If Rey stays active for just another year, then it has to be Rey winning this one.
Alrighty. Anyways, next match, we got a four-way fatality blah 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 tag team women's match. I don't even know what this is for. But anyway,
WrestleMania showcase fatal four-way tag team. It's not for anything. It's to get these people
on the
TV
card
at Mania. 100% It's about not leaving these people.
Can I get the names first, and then you can explain it?
Absolutely. Just go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. You are so kind, sir.
I know.
So
it's...
kind. Anyways, we got Ronda Rousey and Shayna Baszler versus Chelsea Green. Look at that! And Sonya Deville. Why?
my queen! With Sonya Deville.
We got Shotzi and Natalya versus Liv Morgan and Raquel Rodriguez. But that's who cares, guys? Chelsea Green's in. We already know who's gonna win. We already know Chelsea Green's gonna win. She's gonna win all by herself. She doesn't even need Sonya Deville.
No, and the last match is Ronda and Shayna.
I just said that first.
I forgot. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that doesn't really seem to be anything for this.
I mean,
these ones get a crack at the women's title.
That's what I thought it was before.
That could happen.
I mean, that's what I'm thinking. Maybe it could be for, and they're just not telling us. Because I mean, it's like
on the actual show, it just pops up with, you know, oh, and the winner gets a crack at whoever won yesterday.
Yeah.
In the damage control.
So I don't even know. I think it's gonna be. I mean, it's gonna be a very interesting match. I don't know how good this is gonna be.
No, I mean four-way matches. Eight people in a four-way match.
It's kind of like it's.
It can be. It can be a bloody mess. That's what it can be.
If it's not coordinated right, it could be disastrous.
Yeah.
Disastrous.
It's one of those things that can just go so.
But
so,
it will never
so
be Chelsea
wrong.
Green's fault.
And it's all. It's also one of those matches that really needs a lot of time if it's going to work.
Yes.
To give everyone a chance to shine, and they're not going to get a lot of time because there's a lot of other matches on the card that's going to get a lot more. So yeah, I'm. I don't have the biggest expectations for this, but I'm pretty sure Liv and Raquel is going to win.
Yeah, I'll go with that.
I don't even know what I'm basing it on, just that those two really need...
Because one is really short and one is really tall?
Yeah, I mean, to a certain degree, but I think Raquel really needs a boost.
Yes.
Liv Morgan is clearly established as a main star now, and if damage control retains, then having faces... go against damage control would make more sense than any of the others, really.
Damage control.
Yeah, I mean, if they retain the titles and Liv Morgan and Raquel could then challenge them.
They don't have the titles.
Don't they?
No! Becky and Lita have the titles.
Yeah, well, if damage control... like I said, this is predicated on damage control winning the day before. Pay attention!
But they're not going for the titles, Tim.
I'm pretty sure the titles are on the line.
No, they're not.
Pretty sure they are.
I don't think they are.
I think you're wrong.
Go look.
Go look. I don't. There isn't anything about it. I just.
Yeah, exactly. You don't even know because they're not. Why would it be a safe tag?
Maybe they are. And you just don't understand.
No. I think you're wrong.
Moving on.
No.
I still think Liv and Raquel is going to win it.
Yeah, I really don't know.
If it's not,
I would
him,
like
it's to going
see,
to be Ronda.
I mean, I would like to see Shotzi win, but no, that's just.
Oh,
impressive.
I would always love to see Shotzi win. I mean, I would love to see Chelsea and Sonya win, just because I would love to see what those two could do together. I think they could be hilarious, but it's not going to be them. Chelsea.
Darn.
Chelsea Green is too much of a. Comedy character right now.
Darn.
To
I'm really
win
disappointed.
Like
no, I can't wear my Chelsea Green shirt and just be all happy
no.
about it. No, darn. It's crap.
I'm so gonna buy you a Chelsea Green
Don't
shirt.
Don't you fucking dare. Alright, well, let's stick with the Fatal 4-Way, shall we? Let's do the men's. Because why not?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Why not?
They can also
all right.
Like
they can do. Yeah, they can have some fun too. So we got the team of Braun Strowman, Ricochet versus the Alpha Academy versus the Street Profits versus the Viking Raiders.
With Valhalla. I don't know why they renamed Sarah Logan Valhalla. I mean,
because
it makes
Sarah
sense
Logan.
For the Viking thing, but
yeah, I'm about to say because it doesn't makes more sense. The Viking Raiders versus still there's Sarah Logan.
Well, I mean, it's not like I guess Eric and Ivar and Sarah. Well, I suppose. I have no bloody clue who's going to win this one. None.
I mean, you got four good. Teams here, and it's like, I don't even know, and if it's for the titles, I don't know.
I don't know. I mean, it could be anyway. I would like to see Alpha Academy win it, just because the Otis storyline is amusing me
Ortiz.
Somehow.
Otis.
With the maximum male models are amusing me right now.
Yeah,
but I don't know. It could be. I mean, Street Profits is still the Street Profits, right?
Yes.
They are proper with the Usos now completely out for the foreseeable. Not the Usos. Sorry, with the New Day out now for the foreseeable future. Street Profits is clearly the second most, like the second highest level of
the best tag teams
in the company outside of the Usos, unless of course AEW's FTR is coming back, which I really hope so, because letting them go was so stupid. But I'll put my money on Alpha Academy, but it could be any of them. It really could be.
You know, like the whole thing with also with Ricochet and Braun has been going pretty well too.
I love that team. I mean, they could be an awesome team. It's got shades of Team Little Big, right?
Yeah.
Ricochet instead. I love those two. I don't mind the Viking Raiders either. They're a bit bland, but they're fine.
Yeah, they're like vanilla ice cream.
It's
okay.
It's one of those matches again that's probably going to be a bit of a mess, and it's not for anything officially, so bleh.
It's for you, the viewers, to watch.
Yeah, basically, it's to get these people a WrestleMania check. That's what it is.
Hey man, I don't think.
Yeah. I'll put my money on Alpha Academy. Just because I feel like they have the strongest storyline going right now.
Alright. Well, I'll go with you. Anyways, next match! Got the Intercontinental Championship match. It's a triple threat match. It would be Gunther versus Drew McIntyre versus Sheamus. I think Sheamus should win.
I think Sheamus should win, and I will say that from a match perspective, not a storyline perspective, not like an emotional perspective, from a pure match perspective, this can end up being the best match of the entire WrestleMania card.
Yeah, like, I agree.
Both nights. I could see these three just absolutely tearing the house down. Well, I'm pretty sure
the match between him, Gunther, and Sheamus was just incredible. So if you add Drew McIntyre into the mix, it's like...
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Oh
this
my
could
gosh.
Be, oh god, this could be so
You know,
great.
There's always going to be some, like, some shenanigans, because it is a triple threat, and there's no qualifications in a triple threat, so it's like...
Yeah, and we have Imperium brawling the ringside, I'm sure.
Yeah, and then we have the Brawling Brutes.
And Brawling Brutes, of course, yeah. I want to see Sheamus win, because I feel like Sheamus have earned it.
Yes.
Based on the last
I mean, it's like, it's the one, I want him to win, because it's like the one belt that's been eluding him for, like, the longest.
And it would give him, like, the Grand Slam.
Yes, and I think he deserves it.
I think Gunther has had it so long now, he's had it, like, longer than anyone else in the 2000s, since the turn of the millennium. It's time for him to lose, and I think Gunther is getting ready to be put into a main title match.
And I think that's
like
good.
A top card. Like
yes.
Main card match.
And I think that's good because he deserves it. I mean, especially
Absolutely
like... Especially that
it.
After Royal Rumble. Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
So, yes.
So, I could see Sheamus winning this and then feuding with McIntyre.
Yes.
For a while. Again. I mean, it's fine.
I like to see them feud. I enjoy their feuds.
It's entirely fine. So that's my money. I put my money on Sheamus.
Same.
No.
Alright. Well, let's go to the next match. I'm gonna switch it up a bit. Let's go with the Undisputed match with Roman Reigns versus Cody Rhodes. You're excited. I can tell by the size of your voice. I mean,
okay, listen,
Cody has to win!
This is actually the first time in a very long time where I'm having to fight down feelings of excitement. Because, I am actually getting excited for this, because Cody Rhodes have to win this. He have to. I know there is a theory that they want to keep Roman champion for another 2 months so he can say he's been champion for 1,000 days straight. But, I mean, there is no sense in that. None whatsoever. It's like Sting losing to Hogan in 97. I mean, and he did, which was a fuck up. like ultimate fuck up and probably destroyed WCW, or at least started the decline from there. Cody has to win, and I want to see Cody. And you know, I think these two, first of all, these two are going to have an absolutely spectacular match. Cody winning this at Mania, getting his Mania moment, taking the world title in WWE, and dethroning Roman Reigns, it's going to be one
it's
of
like,
those.
It has Mania to be. It's kind of just like kismet, you know? It's kind of like it has to happen.
Like, it's going to be one of those Mania moments we can still talk about in 20 years. Like, when Toria and I in 20 years are doing favorite Mania moments of all time, like, you know, Cody dethroning Roman Reigns would absolutely be on such a list. But it's still, it's Roman Reigns and it's WWE.
Yes,
right?
And it's always like you have your high hopes and you're like excited, and it's like
it
I don't
so
want
to
be too
WWE
excited
because
it's like okay, it's WWE. And
it would be so WWE to have the most amazing 2-day card, and everyone is like up on the very edge of everything, like millions of people, like 90,000 in the arena. However many can be there. 50,000 in the arena.
Just two people, Tim. Just two
70,000 in SoFi.
Just
so,
two people,
you know,
Tim. Just two people.
Just two people, yeah. Like, everyone in the arena up and running. Everyone watching the show, either on TV or on the network. Anywhere, just up and running, and Roman takes it, and everyone goes home angry. Like, it would be so WWE, but it just has to be Cody. It has to be.
It has to be. It just gotta be. I'm gonna put my money on Cody. If I get broke,
because,
I'm just gonna kick Cody's ass.
Just because if it's not, I'm like, then Triple H needs to be fired.
Yes.
If he's actually still booking, because
No.
You can't do that. You literally cannot.
You
do
cannot
that.
Do that, sir.
No. Even if you then do the fact where he then comes back and then wins it at SummerSlam or something.
Look, who cares?
No, that's not how that feud is going to work.
Right.
It cannot work like that. It just can't.
Right.
It has to be Rogue Cody King it and then having like a bloodline collapse.
Alright, well,
with the feuding.
Well, okay, the reason why I put Pim first because I want to talk about the next match.
It's
connected to the other match we just talked about.
Of course.
So we got the Undisputed Tag Team Championships. We got the Usos versus Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. I think, obviously, we all know, or it should be, that the Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn should win. Right.
I mean, of course they should. There is, again, this is one of those where it's like, how could you possibly write it differently based on everything that has happened?
I think that this match, obviously this match is going to be before the Cody Rhodes and Roman match. This match needs to be first, so that can have a little bit of fear on Roman's end. Because obviously Roman's gonna be like, well, if you guys lost your belt, y'all need to help me with my belt, and then maybe that could be the beginning of this fall thing. Maybe, I don't know, because
he would push to start out the second day.
Yeah,
it would make sense in a lot of ways.
I think so. If not the first match, the third match, but like not too close to Roman's match.
No, not immediately before.
Right.
Definitely not immediately before. Agree.
I was thinking about that. Yeah, I was like, it has to be like that, because then I want to just put like a little bit of fear in like Roman, because I mean like Roman,
exactly.
Like Cody Rhodes and Solo Sokoa had a match on Raw this Monday.
Raw, yeah.
And they were both undefeated, and Cody Rhodes won. So that could be, like, a little bit, like, intimidating to Roman. Like, well, he just beat, like, one of my best family members, whatever. Because he's been undefeated all this time. So
I mean, Cody winning on the go-home show.
Yeah.
But again,
you know,
this is different. This is just a different.
This is right. Yeah, this is a different thing. I think. I was kind of like, oh man, I wish he would have lost because like I feel more better because usually
he couldn't do that because if Solo had won, no one would have seen Cody as a credible as a
yeah exactly that's the same thing too. I was just like
I don't think you can put anything into the fact
I would have liked either, well, not for him to lose, but either like the Usos to disqualify. I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
That would have been fair too, but like, oh, okay.
Yeah, but no, I think I don't think you can put anything into that.
Yeah.
But no, I agree with you. I do think so. I think this should be a match where maybe Solo tries to intervene in this or something, but I mean, Owens and Sammy just have to win
this. They gotta win this one. I mean.
And again, Usos lose. Then Roman loses, and then we have the bloodline collapse, which is another story that they can drag out until SummerSlam, and it would be an amazing story to tell.
Right, exactly.
Fantastic story to tell. I put my money on that. It's WWE. Somehow I would not be surprised if we sit here in a week and just shake our heads at how they could fuck up something so elemental. But I do have faith in Hunter that he's gonna make this work.
Yeah, I do too. You know, I was looking at these matches and I was like writing them down and everything. You know how most of the WrestleMania matches, they have like good storylines. They got like something that you have to be passionate about. I have no passion for this WrestleMania. I really don't. I mean, I want to see it. I think it's going to be good. But, like, the storylines, other than, like, maybe the Bloodline storyline, and I don't even want to have passion for that. I feel like I'm forced to have passion for that.
I do get your point. That's another reason why I mentioned the thing with Bianca and Asuka before, where it feels more like a match than a feud.
Like,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, it's like... I mean, some of them, they got...
There's very little in this I am emotionally invested in.
I'm like, I just want this to be over. Like, the bloodline, I just wanted to be over and have these people lose.
Yeah,
that's the only passion that I have.
I mean, I want to see the bloodline lose because they have been
dominating forever.
This is really WWE's. They've had plenty before, but more than anything else, again, this is Starrcade 97, where Hogan didn't lose clean to Sting.
Yes.
1997, Hogan loses clean to Sting, NWO disbands. WCW would still have been existing today. It would, because there was a whole behind the scene with Turner Broadcasting and AOL, that's fine, but they wouldn't have had the dramatic decline that they had after that. This is sort of the same. Like,
true.
I'm invested in this because it's been a really good story with Sammy and Kevin and the twins, and just Roman and Cody. But I understand what you mean. That there's very little else. There's a lot of other matches that I'm super looking forward to, but there's very little else that I'm emotionally invested in.
Yeah, it's like, you know, I'm looking at it, and I'm just like, no, there's nothing here. I'm like, oh yeah, I can't wait for this to finally come down. It's like, okay, well, you got the Rey, the Mysterio match. It's like, it's been off a while, and it's like, yeah, we've been seeing this coming for a while. Like, yeah, okay, great.
Like, 2 years now, or one year at least.
And you got, like, the women's matches, and then you got, like, these... I'm like, then you got these tag... I'm just like, I don't care. Like, I mean, maybe I'll feel differently after the fact, when it's, you know, but, like, right now, I'm just like, okay. Like, I'm going to enjoy the show because I've always enjoyed WrestleMania. There's not a really WrestleMania
A lot of good matches on the card. Again, there's a lot of matches I want to see.
Yeah.
But there's very few feuds want to see.
It's not like when we first, like, met each other with the 2018 WrestleMania.
Exactly.
That one was 19, like...
I think, by the way.
I think it's 18.
I can't remember. It was the one where Kofi won the title, at least.
I think it's 18.
Whatever.
It could be 19. I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Whatever.
Kofi won. Becky Lynch became the first, you know,
Triple crown.
Double belt. Seth Rollins got his ass kicked still. Beat Brock Lesnar. I mean, it was just like, wow. But yeah. I don't know. Let's see what happens. I will see what happens. Like, I'm not saying I'm not excited. I'm just not as excited as I normally would be, but...
No, I feel like the build-up to this has been lacking emotional investment.
Yes, I feel like everything's been lacking. I feel like it's been so bloodlined and everybody else is, like, backburned.
I don't know if I could have developed a bit, like, I don't know if I could personally have set up a better card. I don't think I could, necessarily, but emotionally there is still some investment that could be better. That's what I want to say.
Definitely. I don't know, maybe it's also because I haven't been paying attention to SmackDown and Raw that much. I could be it. I don't know, but...
Yeah, possibly.
Oh, well. Anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching. Yeah. Don't forget, WrestleMania starts on April 1st. No, it's not a fool.
Nope.
It really starts on Saturday.
Yeah.
And, yeah, also, make sure that... Well, Tim won't be, streaming, because he'll be doing other things.
I won't be streaming, because...
He'll be doing other things!
I will be doing other things for WrestleMania, yes.
Yes. He won't be streaming today. And... Yep. Oh, also, don't forget to check out my theme... Guessing theme songs. Hope you guys are enjoying that. I had fun doing it. And...
Yeah, super fun.
I'll see you guys next time. Maybe sooner. Who knows? Okay. Yay. Bye!
Bye! Don't you